In 2024, are you still using Windows 10 or Windows 8 just because you are encountering error messages like this? Or you are aware that your PC does not have 8th generation or newest Intel processor? Don't worry. Whatever the reason you are unable to upgrade to Windows 11, today I have simple steps to help you to upgrade without messing up with registry or any complicated setting. So without any further ado, let's jump into these steps. Now before we upgrade to Windows 11, you need to know that there are some minimum hardware requirements. Typically Windows 11 require more modern PC, but for our process, if you have more than 4GB of RAM and at least 16GB of space on your C drive, that's enough to install Windows 11. Having an SSD instead of SSD will significantly improve your overall experience with the Windows 11. Now let's start these steps by checking how much space we have on our C drive. To do this, go to My PC and check the available space on your C drive. As you can see, I have more than 16GB of free space, so we are good to proceed. If you don't have enough space, try to remove some files from your downloads folder or other folders like documents, photos, and videos. Once you have at least 16GB of free space on your C drive, the very first thing you need to do is right click on the start button and click on disk management. This will open the disk management window. Next, we have to create a virtual hard disk, and for that, click on action, then go to create VHD. Click on browse and navigate to your C drive. Create a new folder called VHD, select it and click on open. Give a file name. As we have used VHD earlier, let's call it also as VHD for the simplification. And then click on save. Now change the virtual hard disk size from MB to GB and set it to 16GB. Leave the rest of setting as it is on their default and click on OK. Now you can see bottom right hand side that virtual disk creation has started. Once it is done, you should see another disk listed below your main disk, which is not initialized. Click on the space where not initialized is mentioned. Then right click on it and click on initialized disk. Now in the open window, make sure GPT is selected and click on OK. You will now see the status of virtual disk changed to online. Now we need to create a simple volume from this newly created virtual space. To do this, select the block of unallocated space. Right click on it and click on new simple volume. Now click next, next, and next again. When you reach the volume label step, call it VUSB for a virtual USB. Click on next and then finish. This will create the virtual drive. Now close disk management, open your file explorer and go to this PC. You should see the virtual USB drive here, which should be 16GB in size. Now moving to the next step where we have to create a Windows 11 ISO image. And for that, open your web browser and do a Google search for Rufus. Click on the official Rufus webpage result. Scroll down to download section and download either 64-bit or 32-bit standard version of Rufus. Do not download the portable version. Once downloaded, open the file, click yes on the updates and Rufus will open on your computer. Now once it is open, it will automatically detect the virtual USB driver by default. If not, select it from the drop-down menu. Now click on the little arrow next to select, then click on download. Next, click on the download button. A window will open to download an ISO image file. In this window, leave Windows 11 selected and click continue. Now a new drop-down release will pop out. Leave the latest release selected and click on continue again. Again, in the edition, leave the default edition selected and click continue. Now the most important step is to select the language, which should be the same currently installed in your computer. And to check the language currently installed in your computer, go to the search bar of your PC and type PowerShell. Now right click on the PowerShell and select Run as Administrator. Once PowerShell is open, type get wind system local E and hit enter. Now you can see the language. For me, it's English US, So I will make the same selection in Rufus as well and click continue. Now next, leave the default 64-bit option and click download. Save the ISO file to your downloads folder. Now you can see download is in progress. Since the file size is more than 6 GB, it will take some time to get downloaded. Now once the ISO file is downloaded, it will automatically selected under format section of Rufus. Change the volume level something like Win11 for Windows 11 and click start. In the open pop-up, make sure all the boxes are selected and click OK. You might get a warning message saying all the data on device will be destroyed. Since we have created this virtual drive for this only, click OK to proceed. Now Rufus will start writing the Windows 11 installation files to the virtual USB drive. Once finished, the status will turn to ready. Now close Rufus and open File Explorer, go to this PC and you will see the virtual USB is now changed into Win11 drive. Double click on the Win11 drive to open it. Then double click on the setup file. Click yes if prompted to launching the Windows 11 installation wizard. Now you can see Windows is preparing to install Windows 11. Now from the open setup window, click on change how setup downloads updates. To make the process simple, select the option not right now as this can be updated post Windows 11 installation and click next. Now Windows will scan your system to prepare for the installation, which might take some time. Accept the license terms and Windows will check if your PC have enough space to install Windows 11. Next, you will see the options for how you want to install Windows 11. We have selected install Windows 11 and keep personal files and apps. If you want to make changes, click on change what to keep. You can choose to keep personal files and delete apps by selecting the second option, or delete everything and install a fresh copy of Windows 11 by selecting the last option. Here we will go with the first option, but you can choose what suits you best. Now click on next and we are ready to install Windows 11. Click on install to start the process. Your Windows upgrade is now in progress. This process will take some time and your system might restart several times. Once it is done and you start your PC, you will be running on Windows 11 with the latest features. To verify, open File Explorer, right click on this PC and go to Properties. Under Windows Specification, you will see which version of Windows 11 you are running and when it is installed. Now if you think your PC performance has dropped and you want to go back to Windows 11, click on Windows Update, go to Update History. Under Recovery, you have an option, go back. Click on it and follow the instruction to revert back to Windows 11. But remember, this option is only available for the first 10 days. Post that, you will not find this option. However, if you prefer to continue with Windows 11, you can go back and download and install the latest Windows updates. So that's all from this video. If you encounter any issue or have any question, feel free to drop those in the comment section, I will reply you back. And if you successfully upgraded to Windows 11, give a thumbs up to this video and share with your friends and family so that they can also upgrade to Windows 11 with few simple steps. And you do not forget to subscribe our channel for more amazing tech videos. Thanks for watching and I will see you in my next video.